Most of you know about Christopher Columbus, this Italian who had a heartbeat because of his grandfather. His grandfather was given a revelation from God that they were to go west. He was the first guy that said, "Go west, young man." He was killed preaching in an Islamic town, and they took him on a ship back to Genoa, and he died pointing west. Christopher Columbus grew up with that story in his mind. He never forgot it. Christopher Columbus says in his diary, "I know it was God who put in my heart to sail to the Indies." And he's got a parenthesis in his diary that says, "His hand was upon me." Christopher means Christ bearer. But maybe you don't know how Christopher got his three little ships, the Santa Maria, the Nina, and the Pinta. He first went to John II, who was the king of Portugal. And he said, "John," he was working as a map maker in Lisbon, Portugal. And he said, "John, would you fund a trip? I know how to get to the New World. I know how to get," he thought he was going to Japan, but he made it to Cuba. But anyway, he said, "I know how to do it." And John II of Portugal said, "No." He went to Henry VII in England. And he said to Henry VII, "If you'll fund this, I'll bring all the gold back to England." And Henry VII turned him down. He went to King Ferdinand and Queen Isabella of Spain. And he said, "Would you fund me a trip? It's going to cost about $1 million, our money, to do that." And they thought he was crazy. And they turned him away. And now this young man, Christopher, was totally depressed. He had a son who was studying to be a monk. And he went to a man who was a priest named Juan Perez. And he talked to him in this monastery, and he shared his heart with him about how heartbroken he was. And in that monastery, on that night when he had lost all hope, what he did not know was that Juan Perez had the ear of Isabella, the Queen of Spain. He was the one man that could get another audience. And Columbus didn't know that. And when he shared his heart about how God had worked in his heart, and he quoted the passage in Isaiah about being a light to the nations, and he said he felt like that God had called him to be a light to the nations. Juan Perez, a monk in a monastery, sent a messenger to Queen Isabella and said, "You got to hear this man. This man is from God." Queen Isabella sent a messenger back and said, "Send him up here." They were outside the city of Granada. The Islamic forces had taken southern Spain, and now they had had a war that was going on for a number of years, and all of the Islamic forces were now in the city of Granada in southern Spain, and they had built a city outside of it and had laid siege to the city, trying to remove the Islamic influence out of the country of Spain. Let me tell you what happened. In a time when there was no hope, the one man that Columbus talked to was the one man who could get the ear of the queen. Now, they sent back and said, "Send Columbus up here. We want to talk to him." All right? They even sent him some money to dress up nice. And he was so excited, so he got all of his stuff together. And he's on his way to meet with the queen, going from Lisbon up to Granada. Let me tell you what happened. Without any warning, without any kind of premonition, the dawn broke, the Islamic flag was pulled down in Granada. Unbelievably, the Moors had agreed to surrender to Queen Isabella. Unbelievable. That was unthinkable. All of a sudden, those huge doors, the gates of the city, began to swing open. And the king of the Moors, followed by his men on horseback, came out of Granada, Spain, and made their way down this road to where the king and queen were. And he got off of his horse. walked up to the queen and knelt and surrendered. He surrendered the city that day. And it was the very day that Christopher Columbus was to meet with the king and the queen. And the reason that Isabella funded Columbus's trip to discover the New World was in gratitude to God for giving them the victory that happened on that same day. Now you tell me that's coincidence. Oh, well, you know, those things just happen. There's a Hebrew word for that. Baloney. Now let me tell you something else. In the providence of God, America was not discovered by Columbus. You got to know that. He came as far as the West Indies, but he never set foot on North America soil. There was another Italian named John Cabot. John Cabot talked Henry VII, 5 years later, into financing his trip. That's why our background is in England and not in Spain. You see, if Columbus had landed on our shores, we would have had that strong Spanish Catholic influence in this country, which they now have in Mexico, because that's where they went. You remember Cortez and those guys? They landed in the Mexican area and started up the West Coast. That's why Mexico is such a strong Catholic nation, is because of the Spanish. The French settled north, what we now know as Quebec, as Canada. But they never came south. And John Cabot, an Italian, claimed the entire east coast of what we now know as the United States for England. You think that was an accident? No. You think that was not the providence of God? Because in England, in Henry VIII, they broke with the Roman Catholic Church, and England became a Protestant nation. And as a result of that, the people that came to this country were mainly Protestants, and they were not Roman Catholics, and the whole different thing was changed. And do you think that was an accident? No, it was not.